Hello, my name is Dr. Carlo Oger, emergency physician. In this video, we're going to talk about emergency services documentation. Levels 1 through 5 of the documentation of the patient's emergency room visit, critical care codes, and special tips and tricks on how to properly document what you've done. There are essentially 5 levels of care in the emergency services record, from 99281 to 99285, and one additional level of coding which is of extreme importance. It is the 99291 code for critical care. Let's begin the discussion. This code, 99281, represents the lowest possible billable code for a patient's emergency department visit. It usually represents minor, self-limited problems. Problem that runs a definite and prescribed course, transient in nature, and not likely to permanently alter health status or has a good prognosis with management and compliance. These include interventions like suture removal, which are uncomplicated, wound rechecks, but also tetanus toxoid administration or vaccination administration, and several uncomplicated insect bites. The code 99282 represents a level 2, and it's a low risk. Low risk of morbidity without treatment is low. Little to no risk of mortality without treatment. Full recovery without functional impairment is expected. These include things like administrations of over-the-counter medications like Motrin or Tylenol, a tetanus shot, tests done by the ED staff like urine dips, hemocults, AccuChecks, visual acuity, dressing change, and suture removal for more complicated, potentially infected sutures. For example, a patient who presented with a painful sunburn with blisters on his back, a child with impetigo localized only to the face and no systemic symptoms, an ED visit for minor traumatic injury of an extremity with localized pain, swelling, and bruising, an ED visit for a healthy patient with red or swelling listic lesion on the back, an ER visit for a rash in both legs like poison ivy or contact dermatitis, and so on. The 99283 code. This represents a moderate complexity case. The risk of morbidity without treatment is moderate, moderate risk of mortality without treatment, uncertain prognosis or increased probability of prolonged functional impairment. Interventions that can be included in this code include heparin or saline lock, crystalloid IV therapy, lab test, plain x-rays, alteration of prescription medications, fluorescein stain of the eye, Foley catheter, straight catheter, and so on. A couple examples of visits that could represent this level of care would be a visit for a sexually active female with vaginal discharge who is afebrile without abdominal pain or back pain, an ED visit for a well-appearing 8-year-old who has a fever, diarrhea, abdominal cramps, and is tolerating oral fluids and is not vomiting, an ED visit for an inversion ankle injury, unable to bear weight, an ED visit for acute pain associated with foreign body or pain in the eye, ED visits for a young healthy patient who sustained blood and head injury with localized swelling and bruising without subsequent confusion, loss of consciousness, or memory deficit. The 99284 code represents high complexity, a level 4. ED visits for head injury with brief loss of consciousness or an actual concussion. ED visits for elderly patient who has fallen and complained of right hip pain or unable to walk. ED visits for flank pain and hematuria like kidney stones. And ED visit for female with low abdominal pain and vaginal discharge. Some interventions that fall under this category are listed here. And the level 5. This represents the highest level of complexity. The risk of morbidity without treatment is high due to extreme to moderate to high risk of mortality without treatment or high probability of severe prolonged functional impairment. Here are some list of things that fall under a level 5. Also, an ED visit for complicated overdose requiring aggressive management to prevent side effects. An ED visit for rapid onset of elevated heart rate requiring IV drugs. An ED visit for an active upper GI bleed. An ED visit for a motor vehicle collision. Comes to ED immobilized and has symptoms compatible with intra-abdominal injuries or multiple extremity injuries. a ER visit for sudden onset of the worst headache ever, with stiff neck, nausea, inability to concentrate, suggestive of bad disease. An ED visit for new onset cerebral vascular accident. An ED visit for acute febrile illness associated with shortness of breath or altered level of consciousness. Simple post indicators of a 99285 or a level 5 coding. Most admissions, most transfers, if the patient required IV medications, multiple IM medications, or the need for multiple ancillary or special studies. The 99291 code could include interventions from the previous level plus any of the following. The first hour of critical care for septic shock, following relief of ureteral obstruction from stones. First hour of critical care for acute respiratory failure from asthma. Patients who come with cardiac arrest and were resuscitated. A six-month-old with hypovolemic shock secondary to diarrhea and dehydration. Critical care for respiratory failure secondary to pneumonia are some examples of this level of care. Critical care is the only emergency service code that is solely time-based. For billing purposes, HPI, review system, and exam are not even considered. But at least 30 minutes is required to qualify for a 99291. Now let's talk about the medical decision-making. This is very important. Two out of the following three columns needs to be met to qualify for a 99285 or level 5 code. There has to be, on number one, at least four problem points. Number two, four data points. Number three is high risk. Problem points. The nature and number of clinical problems are quantified into problem points by referring to the following table. All ER visits pretty much get a 3 or 4 points. You must have a differential diagnosis that needs to be at least 2 entries to qualify for high complexity based on the chief complaint of high severity. The more differential diagnosis equals, the more potential for higher medical decision-making complexity. It takes at least 2 differential diagnoses to drive diagnostic testing or review old records and tests or discussion with family or discussion with another healthcare provider to rule in or rule out disease, ultimately driving up the medical decision making. The number of possible diagnoses and/or the number of management options that must be considered is based on the number and types of problems addressed during the encounter, the complexity of establishing diagnosis, and the management decisions that are made by the physician. In general, decision-making with respect to a diagnosed problem is easier than that of an identified but undiagnosed problem. The number and type of diagnosed tests performed may be an indicator of the number of possible diagnoses. Problems that are improving or resolving are less complex than those problems that are worsening or failing to change as expected. Another indicator of the complexity of diagnostic or management problems is the need to seek advice from other healthcare professionals. Some important points that should be kept in mind when documenting the number of diagnoses or management options are: for each encounter, an assessment, clinical impression, or diagnosis should be documented, which may be explicitly stated or implied in documented decisions regarding management plan and/or further evaluation. For a presenting problem without an established diagnosis, the assessment or clinical impression may be stated in the form of differential diagnosis or as possible, probable, or rule-out diagnosis, as long as there is a primary diagnosis. The initiation of or changes in treatment should be documented. Treatment includes a range of management options, including patient nursing instruction, therapies, and meds. If referrals are made, consultations requested, advice sought, the record should clearly indicate to whom, where the referral or consultation is made, or from whom advice is requested. Data points. The amount and complexity of the data reviewed are quantified into data points by referring to the following table. It is important to check the radiology interpretation box as interpret by MD doctor that gives you 2 points, or discuss with radiologist only gives you 1 point. You can get data points from simply ordering tests or deciding to obtain old records. To be safely considered an interpretation, clinical indication needs to be documented. At least 3 components of the typical interpretative elements documented, and at least 3 pertinent positive and negative findings documented. For example, an EKG needs rate, rhythm, axis, intervals, ST segments. An X-ray varies depending on the type of X-ray you order, chest X-ray versus a KUB or extremities. The data point sections are not mutually exclusive. Thus, ordering an X-ray gives you 1 point, and indicating direct visualization gives you 2 points, will command for 3 total data points. Only the medically reasonable and necessary services for the condition at the encounter are considered when selecting EM service. This table of risk shows you the level of risk, minimal, low, moderate, and high, the presenting problems that can be found under that, diagnostic procedures that can usually be found, and the management options that can be found according to each level. One way to work around it, if you see a management option that involves IV drips or intubation, that already puts you at high risk and high level of documentation. Reimbursement is directly related to proper and complete documentation. So what are the minimum documentation requirements for emergency department EM services? Level 1, a 99281, requires 1 HPI, 1 exam finding, and a straightforward medical decision making. A level 2, 99282, requires 1 HPI, 1 review system, and 2 physical exam findings, a low complexity medical decision making. A level 3, 99283, 1 HPI, 1 review system, 2 physical exam findings, and a moderate complexity medical decision making. A level 4, 99284, requires 4 HPI findings, 2 review systems, 1 past family social history, and 4 exam findings, and a moderate complexity medical decision making. A level 5 or a 99285 requires 4 HPI, 10 review systems, 2 past family social history, 8 exam findings, and a high complexity medical decision making. As a recommendation, the emergency room physician should attempt to document a level 5 on all charts. That means the 4-10-2-8 rule, 4 HPI, 10 ROS, 2 past family social history findings, and 8 physical exam findings. And the level 99233, which refers to critical care codes. For floor codes with less than 30 minutes in time, plus procedures can be billed. To properly bill for 99233, 2 of the 3 components listed above must be documented. Floor codes with at least 30 minutes of the critical care bill is a 99291.